I'm just a bird boy, wretch on the joys you bring me, and all the words you sing me to sleep. So don't worry, dry your eyes, you'll be waking to bluer skies, and let those dirty rain clouds fly. And don't say you won't play, I'm tired and I need a voice like silver to send me on my way. And don't turn your face and pretend you've said all you have to say, like that's any way to end a perfect day. Traveling this world on our own, traveling till we find our home. And don't say you won't play, I'm tired and I need a voice like silver to send me on my way. And don't turn your face and pretend you've said all you have to say, like that's any way to end a perfect.
Alright, I'm Michael McGovern. I am playing a band now called Michael and the Moonshine. Set up, we've got sax and double bass and whatever. I love harmonies and things like that, so we're trying to add all that into the mix. We're playing a few gigs and we've got a song out now called Staring Out Your Window on Spotify. So if you want to go and give it a listen, then feel free to do so. But we take a lot of music inspirations for like the 60s and 70s music. I like a lot of Bob Dylan, Bruce Springsteen, Paul Simon's a big one as well. So we're not trying to like replicate it, but maybe try to bring back some of that through our own music. Like the idea of songwriting, a lot of people writing songs and originality in their music, but it's hard to write songs yourself. So if I'm sitting about in the house with my guitar trying to write songs myself, you've got nobody there to say, oh, that's a good idea. Or I like that, we better change that. So you're by yourself, you've got absolutely no confidence. So I like when we've got the band and a couple of people from there and you can bounce ideas off each other. Someday, like my pal Michael, also in a band around Michael, he's kind of really play the piano, but he accidentally will sit down as I'm playing something and accidentally hit a few wee notes, play it by accident often, and then that will maybe be the start of your tune. That is the start of the melody in the song we've got on Spotify just now. So I love playing music with the band. I love hearing the full band together. I love practicing, love writing tunes. I wish I could do all those things a bit better, but thoroughly enjoy doing them and I hope to do them for a very long time. So all right.
staring out the window of my dark room. Bad imagery been rolling round my head. Maybe last night I would stay in my dream, but something came and woke me up instead. Storm clouds come raging, I know, but I can't find you anywhere. Bad news this morning, can't find you anywhere. So give me a drink of something strong and numb in my mind. Stop the twisting and the tumbling in my bed. I wouldn't say I ever treated you too unkind. It's never knew the fickle's in your head. It's too late for sorries, I know, but I can't find you anywhere. So fuck my apology, can't find you
Right, I'm going to show you how I make a cup of tea. So, first of all, I think this is very important that we've got nice pottery or nice china. I'm quite into that now. You've caught me at quite a good time for tea making. I think things need to be matching. Quite enjoy this matching set here. I'd usually maybe put my milk in a wee thing for my guests, but we'll just leave it in the milk carton. That's fine. Right, so boil the kettle. That's fine. Everyone knows how to do that. I think you'd pour it in. Maybe put the spoon in, because you know sometimes the cup can get a wee bit too warm and the spoon will take the heat because the spoon's melt. So pour the tea in, pour the water in. Don't fill it up too high, maybe about 3/4 of the way, that'll do. Leave that in there for a bit. Do it again. I've been trying to figure out the perfect time to leave it. I don't really know. I'd guess it's around about 2 minutes, but I don't know if I can be arse waiting that long here then. Give it a wee bit of a stir. I mean, we don't want to like drain the tea bag too much, but we want to get it moving in there. And wait a wee bit. I'll be playing on my phone. Check what people are saying that to me. Do a wee bit of shopping on Amazon. I bought one of the diffuser things in it. So you buy wee essential oils for it and you put it in, it's like a humidifier, but it gives you nice smells. They're on the wee oils for it on Amazon for £1. So whenever I've got like a spare minute, I go and like buy lavender, buy sweet pea. Then I'm like £10 down by the end of the week. Right, I think we can take the tea bags out now. This is quite important for me, having a wee pot, because you don't want people coming in your house and you're hovering a tea bag in one hand while they drink it with the other, so just put it in the pot of that, nice and easy. Other one goes in the same way. You might see the level of the tea. Shit. The level of the tea decreasing slightly when you take this out, because you see your spoon and your tea bag is going to bring that up a wee bit, like when you get in a bath and it overflows. Now, do you take sugar in your tea? Too. Obviously try not to drop the tea bag back in and burn your hand like I just did there. I only take milk, and I only take the smallest wee bit of milk. People often say to me, what's the point? I just get a wee bit of a colour to the tea. Don't know if you'd be able to see that for there, but it's just a wee bit of a kind of grey colour to the tea there. What about your milk levels? What do you like? And we're going to intoxicate this cup of tea with two sugars. It's a cocktail. See how I'm getting that spin a wee white there so the sugar doesn't go. Spin a shake. I get too much sugar in it. A wee stir. Put everything back. Tea bags in there. Take that, spin it. Lid back in the milk. 2 cups of tea. You know, I think I need to do yoga or something like that, because every time I bend down, my knees just pure click. Warm, but good.
Skyline rolls over her hair, and a million faces ride in the train. They feel their love just slipping away. I swear I never felt a thing, and then your kisses, they burned on my tongue. The empty arms, they stung. And in the dark of night, I felt so alone. Come light the way and follow me home. The morning rain brushes the leaves, it takes the pain and flushes the street. You have my heart, and what is more, you have left me burning at the core. And there's a record skipping in my heart, and a fire in my skin, when I know that you can walk away and never feel a thing. And there are hungry, hungry hearts tonight. I wonder how they felt. It's for you I've waited all these years, and for you I'm waiting still. It's for you I've flooded all these tears, and for you I'm crying still.
That was the last picture I took on my phone. That's my phone. I took a screenshot of Chewing the Fat. No, I took a picture of Chewing the Fat on my Netflix to show my pal John that it was on Netflix, and I was really excited about it. Then he was like, "That, oh, I've known that was there. It was up for about a month." And it pure killed all my joy. So that was last night. So that's a wee bit of a busted first for me, to be honest. Not as excited about it anymore. Who's the first celebrity I remember fancying? Oh wow, I know what it was. When I was about 10 or 11, that show, The Simple Life, was on. And I must admit, it's maybe slightly embarrassing now because I think she's a bit of a junkie, but it was Paris Hilton. Which is better, cats or dogs, and why? Dogs definitely better. I can think about a million reasons. Cats are evil, you don't know what they're thinking. They know what you're thinking. Dogs just want to hug you and love you. Sit up and watch the TV with you. Cats are smarter than you, which is their main downfall. What's my most embarrassing memory? Must be when in school and that scanting thing happened and everyone used to pull down your trousers and that at gym. I mean, it was happening to everybody, so everyone took a bit of it, but it did happen to me. At a time where I had my gym shorts round the wrong way. No, a lot of lasses in school seen marks. We used to show you my perfect pizza. It's got to be pineapples on it. I know a lot of people don't agree with that, but I do like pineapples on a pizza. But then again, I like rocket and like parma ham on a pizza, and I don't think you could merge those three things. Nah, I've just go with that classic Hawaiian. I love that. From past and present, who are my top five dinner party guests? My wee dog Sandy. I'd have him there, and like a wee baby hijack kind of thing. He's 15 now, so probably need to mash his food down for him a wee bit. Who would it be then? Need to say my pal John, or he'd probably have a go at me. Need to throw in my dad. My granda, because he'll probably buy the dinner. What is my biggest fear? It's definitely spiders. I know that's quite a conventional fear, but I just can't stand things. I know everybody says, like, oh, but they can't hurt you and they can't bite you. They're just so terrifying. Like, I couldn't even be in the room with a spider. If I found a magic lamp, what would be my three wishes? I don't want to be that guy who said I'd wish for another 1,000 wishes. Loads of air miles, probably in aeroplanes. Just fly about the world for free. A recording contract. Yeah, one of the big companies. Just a nice new guitar. I'm not picky, just a nice one. If I could call myself 50 years in the future, what would be my first question? I phone myself in the future to ask my question. Oh, I have to get it now, I get it right. Let me think about it. So I have to phone myself in the future, 50 years from now, to ask myself a question. What would that question be? Where are Celtic in the league? Because Brendan Rodgers would probably been one of those wee things in Futurama with their head used to be in like the ice bucket or whatever it was, and then it'd still be alive. You have a robot body, and we'd have like a super team in it. And Lee Griffiths would be like 87, and he'd just be still scoring as many goals as he does now. What do I wish my name was? I'm putting deep thought into these. I'm trying to think about something that'd be good. I quite like the name Robbie. I like it if people call me Rab. I've got a pal called Robbie. But I quite like it to be called Rab. That's quite a cool nickname.